Hey guys, Sherry here from the NFgC crew. How's it going? So this is going to be a weekly twin flame reading for March the 10th until the 17th. But first, I just want to thank you guys all for liking, sharing, subscribing, and commenting on my channel. It is so appreciated. I have done so much soul growth over the past couple of months because of this channel. So I want to thank you guys so much for the support. Also for supporting my cards as well. When I thought about making the cards, it was just out of the blue. I just decided to sit down and start working on them. And next thing I know, we got tarot cards. So I'm not expecting to have a YouTube channel and my own set of freaking tarot cards, so that's awesome. So I'm kind of rolling towards No Fucks Given Tarot. So let me know what you think about that. It is a concept. It is a state of mind where you no longer are engaged in negative behavior, negative thoughts, negative people. So you've reached a state of peace and stillness within your mind. So yeah, that's what not giving a fuck means. So let me know what you think, and if you think it'll roll, you know. But yeah, I just wanted to again thank you guys for all the love that you've shown me, and I hope that I can return it to you. Namaste. Much love. Hi, Sherry here. Welcome to my new space. So, this is going to be a twin flame reading for March the 10th until the 17th. So, I'm going to be using John Holland's Psychic Tarot for the main energy. Call it Baron Reed for the message from the universe. My cards for clarification. And I may pull a couple cards from Osho Zen Tarot. We'll see how I feel. Alright, so, as you know, I pull four cards for the feminine, four for the masculine. But you can relate to either side. Really, we're only talking about the left and right side of the brain. So it all depends on how you're feeling that day. You could be either. So then I will also be pulling five cards in the middle that would represent the union energy. Okay, starting with the feminine, her recent past position. Beautiful. Solar plexus chakra. So this is stepping into your power. It is digging deep within in order to find courage and strength when dealing with a situation. So it seems to me that the divine feminine has stepped into her strength. So I'm going to pull three cards. Wow, awesome. We got judgment. Wow, the Ten of Cups. And holy crap, the Ace of Pentacles. So there's a 10 here, which reduces to a 1, and then we got an Ace, so there's an 11. So, Judgment card. Major transformation has occurred in your recent past. Major, major. The Judgment card talks about seeing things as they truly are. It is a grand awakening. It is a detachment from conditioning, from the lies that you've been telling yourself, the stories that people have been telling you about yourself that you've believed all these years. It is looking at your entire life like it's a movie being projected on the screen here and realizing that it isn't real. It is just an illusion. It is a movie with players, with actors, with, roles that are all being casted in your mind, and then you project it onto a screen and that becomes your reality. But it is an awakening from that, from social conditioning, from material attachments. It is, you know, you coming out of your coffin and brushing the dirt off and rejoicing for being alive and truly seeing the importance of being alive is experiencing every moment of life that you possibly can, and enjoying that and living from the heart. So this represents an ending and a beginning. So grand awakening, epic step up in consciousness. Next we have the Ten of Cups. This is the happily ever after. This is the arrival. It is emotional abundance. It is having the dreams manifested into reality, but it's all about cups. It's all about emotions, feeling emotionally satisfied and arriving at that point where you're just feeling harmony, peace, bliss. The Ace of Pentacles is a brand new beginning in the 3D world. So it is a gift from the universe. It is a seed planted. It is abundance coming towards you. So what I'm getting here from these three cards is that in the recent past, you've really come into your power as divine feminines. You've released yourself from these chains, from the story, and realize that the most important thing is not material possessions, but love, true love. And from that, you gained a great deal of power and strength and stability. And the Ace of Cups, like I said, the Ace of Pentacles is that new start in the 3D world. So it seems like something has been initiated. Abundance is coming towards you as a result of, you know, going through this process. So for the masculine's recent past, nice. Mirroring, wow, I've been noticing a lot in readings lately, this mirroring effect. So that is this card right here. So a seed was planted in his recent past, and it is the coming together, a union. From that, abundance will grow. So yeah, brand new start in the 3D world. Justice card, number 11. So this talks about karma coming back to you in a good way. So what you reap, you sow. She represents the cosmic scales of balance. So it's a cause and effect. And when this card shows up, it means that things turned out in his favor, that justice was served. It also talks about standing in your truth, knowing your truth, and not compromising. So there's a sense that the seed was planted, and it was planted based on his truth. Oh my God, how beautiful. So this is spiritual union. I changed my card. It used to be two people sitting on a beach, so now it is this. It is the coming together of unconditional love. It is pure love. Two souls coming together in a spiritual way. You know, the third eye chakra is activated, the crown chakra is activated, and the heart chakra is activated. You know, so there's this flow of energy and even exchange, give and a take. But it has to do with spiritual union, your higher consciousness. So to recap, this brand new beginning, a start of a foundation, justice has been served, karma is coming back to him in, you know, an amazing way. And the seed that is planted has to do with a spiritual union, a grounding energy, a balance. And another two, the two wands, and that's so beautiful. So these are all twos. So the 11 reduces to a two, and then we got another two and another two. So twos together are union. It's a balance. So the Two of Wands talks about making a decision in the past, and remember this is a past position, that wasn't based on fear. It was based on your highest goals and aims. So you want to achieve your highest potential, see all possibilities, expand your horizon, look out the door and realize that you are connected to consciousness, to the universe. You are, in fact, the universe. So it's an expansive state, but it's also a waiting for a return. You've done the work, you made the decision, you've done the work, and now you're waiting for that final outcome, that final payoff. So yeah, justice will be served. So he will have that harvest returned to him. These are so beautifully. We got judgment and justice over here. So that talks about karma. Then in the middle we have, I know you can't see it, but in the middle we have the Two of Cups and the Ten of Cups. And then a brand new beginning. Like, then we have the Ace of Pentacles. That's so incredible. So next we have the feminine's present position. Holy cow, sacral chakra. You're really getting into your chakras. So this is a number two. It is the place where your emotions are stored. It has to do with your desires, your sexuality, your passions. And so presently you are in your heart chakra space. So three cards for that. Ten of Swords. Wow. The Four of Wands. And the Six of Swords. So the Ten of Swords talks about an ending, a completion of a cycle, major completion. It is feeling like you've been stabbed in the back, you've been under stress, a lot of anxiety, a lot of worry, and it's been consuming your thoughts. It created a mental prison for yourself. And, you know, it's nightmares and fear and guilt of things that transpired in the past. But it is an ending. It is a final cutting away of that negativity. And again, there's that sense of, you know, being out for the count, left for dead on the ground with 10 swords in your back. And then you get up, you rise again. It's a rebirth. It is the completion of the dark night of the soul. Okay, so next we have the Four of Wands. So generally this card is the calling card for me for Twin Flames, the Four of Wands. However, in my deck, I made the 11-11 clock light card. So this has the potential to be the twin flame connection, but it embodies all of its original meaning, which is a completion. It is an arrival. It is abundance, harvest, but it's achieving your goals. Your dreams are manifested. And you are with the love of your life. You've got a beautiful home. It could represent marriage, buying a home or property. It could also represent moving as well. So travel. But it has to do more with that loving warmth and glow that is circulating through you when you feel harmony and peace. And can enjoy life. It's rest. It is accomplishment, achievement. Then we have the Six of Swords, and this talks about finally moving on from the negativity, the negative thoughts, energy, and situations, and you're going from choppy waters to calmer waters. You're finding peace. You're finally ready to move on. And that all has to do with your emotions. So remember that your present position for the feminine is the sacral chakra, and that's where emotions are stored. So she's really getting in touch with her emotions. She wants to move to this restful, peaceful state and sit in front of the fire with her twin flame and just enjoy each other. So it seemed to me like you feminines are putting an end to something. Next, for the masculine's internal environment, or sorry, present position, shadow, the moon card. This is facing your shadow aspect. It is the dark night of the soul also. It is facing your fears head on. All those things that you've avoided, the things that you've pushed down deep, ignored, they're all coming to the surface for you to deal with. And it must be dealt with, otherwise you're never going to be able to move forward. These stories and mental baggage and garbage will always be carried around with you until you're ready to release it. They will always be affecting your personal life and relationships. So in order to really truly, you know, be in that still conscious state, the mental noise needs to be addressed. This could also talk about not really seeing your way clearly. So it's like truths need to be revealed. There's hidden truths. There is, you know, secrecy, or there's a sense that you have to dive deep into your subconscious in order to find the truth. King of Cups, how beautiful. The High Priestess, that's beautiful too. And the Chariot, wow. Okay, the King of Cups, Kurt Cobain. I chose him because he is, you know, the most feeling person that I could think of. He feels everything. His emotions are pure, they're deep, they're generous. But it has more to do with, you know, being in touch with your emotions and being able to share that openly. So I've noticed in the twin flames and personal readings that I've done recently that there is a switch. Last week, the feminine was an open vessel. She was allowing love to be received into her heart. So she was holding open that heart chakra while the masculine was stepping into his power. So now I'm seeing that the masculine is really facing their shadow aspect, you know, in order to release those final things so that he can connect with his emotions and his heart. So now we have the High Priestess. So that represents the divine feminine in her spiritual form. So there's a real sense of being psychically awakened or intuitive by these two cards here together. The King of Cups also kind of represents that psychic intuitive knowing as well, but it's more the Queen of Cups that has that psychic ability, but there's still that intuitive knowing. He could still be, you know, clairvoyant and coming into his psychic ability. So the High Priestess, this is someone who goes within and listens to their inner voice. She is able to reveal unseen things in order to find the truth. So it seems to me, if this doesn't represent the feminine helping and guiding the masculine through the veil process, through the, you know, the shadow, it would represent his energy as becoming more intuitive, you know, getting signs and synchronicities from spirit that is helping him guide him out of the darkness and into his inner knowing so that he can, in fact, open his eyes. heart chakra fully and allow that love in. So we get the chariot as the last card. Another major arcana. These are all major arcanas except for the King of Cups. So the chariot talks about seeing your goal, your vision, and using your strength, your determination, and your pure will to go after that dream and make it happen. It is a movement forward, and it's a very directed, controlled kind of movement. He's taking hold of the reins and he's moving forward towards his highest dreams. So for the near future for the feminine, wow, the universe, the world card, completion of a major cycle. So this is, the cycle could last up to 20 years to complete, but you began the journey as the Fool. You stumbled along the way, you had your heart broken, you found challenges, conflict, obstacles. You overcame your material needs, you awakened to your consciousness, you healed your heart, you found a sense of stillness and peace within yourself. So you are an awakened, loving, open, beautiful spirit shining down as this divine light in the heaven, you know, in the stars, sorry. You are the star in the sky. So this is the way the twins communicate. I like to see this card as representing a twin popping in from the 5D, letting the other twin know that they are always connected, always together as one. So major completion. Again, we got that awakening, judgment in the recent past, releasing the negative energy, which is a completion, 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 and again with the completion. So it is, you're cutting away the negative to allow this beautiful abundance to come towards you. Wow, the High Priest, the Knight of Wands, and the Strength card. Beautiful. So the High Priest is very similar to the High Priestess. However, he is the connection from the 3D to the 5D. He's able to tap into the Akashic records, download information, and then in turn he shares his knowledge with others. So he is able to open his third eye, open his crown chakra, and, you know, be connected to Source. Whereas the High Priestess is able to go tap into the subconscious, go below, into the darkness, into the unseen, and pull up information and knowledge that way. Hold on one moment. Sorry, I just don't want to have to shuffle the cards again. Okay, so yeah, he is using his 5D connection to pop in and say hi to the mass, or the feminine twin flame, and she is doing that on his side by showing up as a High Priestess. So that's pretty crazy. Yeah, so in the near future there's going to be this major completion, and it involves the evolution of your consciousness. It is a completion of a major cycle, 20 years. The Knight of Wands is very similar energy to the Chariot in that, you know, it's a fire energy directed towards a goal. But the Knight of Wands is a focused energy. The Chariot is a little uneasy. There's a sense that you need to gain control in order to move forward, but there's a lot of power behind it. It's triumph, victory. This represents good news coming towards you, but again, it is a directed, forward, fiery energy towards your goal, towards manifesting that dream. So it's basically the same feeling. But whereas this one, you need to take control of those reins. Whereas this one, there's, you know, you can't control fire. It goes where it goes. So this is a movement forward. Then we have the Strength card. Again, you're stepping into your power. Sacral chakra. It is using your strength and determination, your will directed towards a goal. But it also talks about using kindness and compassion and love when dealing with a situation or making a choice. So it seems to me that you have done a lot of work and will achieve whatever dreams you wanted. It will happen for you. And you are going after them. Or that energy could be coming towards you. Okay, so for the masculine's near future. Seven of Swords. This talks about deception and envy. It talks about not knowing the whole truth. You feel like you're being deceived. Now the card that he got below that was the Moon card, so there's that sense of not knowing all there is that you need to know about a situation or a person. You feel like there are hidden truths. You feel like somebody's going to take something from you or sneak away in the middle of the night and not face their fears and confess or talk to you truthfully about something. The Four of Pentacles, the Queen of Swords, and the Three of Wands. So the Four of Pentacles, this talks about being closed off. Either it has to do with things in the material world, like your possessions, holding on to them too tightly, placing too much worth or value on them, and not wanting to share. Or it could mean your energy of being closed off and not letting love in, or you're holding on too tightly to someone. The Queen of Swords is the no-nonsense, no-bullshit queen. She can see through the lies. She cuts the bullshit away. She will tell you like it is. She is all about honest, open communication and speaking your truth. She stands for truth. She holds the truth of justice and it points straight to source. So she's the link, just like the Justice card here. It's all about truth. Or this could represent an air sign. Whoop, boy. Things have been falling and scaring the crap out of me all day in the reading. So the energy is so bizarre. So let me just grab that real quick. My apologies. Okay, so the Three of Wands. This is the card that comes after this card. So there's a sense that he walked, like he planted the seed. He walked out the door, planted the seed, and this is the arrival, the return, the ship's coming in. It is, you know, the harvest, the return. But there's still more work to do. in the, you know, to continue to lay that foundation for the future. But this has to do with those passion, that passionate and desirable goal that you want for the future, that ultimate dream. So this is the beginning of seeing that return. So in the near future, there's a sense that he will be speaking his truth, or a truth will come to light that will move him from this closed off state to this open state. I'm going to pull a Osho card for that, for clarification. That one's got me a little confounded. So what additional messages do you have for the Seven of Swords? Whoa, see what I mean? That's just insanity. Okay, one moment. So I got a bunch of cards here. Let's go through them one by one. The Seven of Pentacles, the pregnant pause. It is putting something into motion in the 3D world. It is doing a lot of hard work, but there's always got to be a wait, a certain period of wait for that return to be shown to you. So that would relate to that Three of Wands, you know, harvest coming in. Then we have the Fool card. That is a brand new beginning in the 3D world. So on the feminine side, we got the completion of the Fool's journey. Here we got that beginning, taking a leap of faith. Wow. Then we have the Wheel of Fortune, which is a wheel of change. I was going to say, holy cow, these are all major arcana so far, but the Seven of Pentacles is not a court earned. Not a major arcana. So yeah, this is the Wheel of Change. This is good luck coming back to you. Then we have the Lover's card. Union, spiritual, or not spiritual union, but twin flame union. Five of Swords talks about conflict and defeat. There's a sense that he needs to walk away from drama. He's no longer engaged in negative energy or negative people. Ten of Wands is a completion. It is carrying too many burdens, and you feel like giving up and walking away. You're to the point of exhaustion, to where the walls are starting to crack and things are going to implode. So it is an end to feeling this way. Nine of Swords talks about a mental prison for yourself. You're unable to sleep at night. The feminine got a similar energy to that. She got the 10. But yeah, it's putting an end to feeling like you've been... it's putting an end to stress and anxiety and fear. No longer fearing things. Nine is nearing the completion of that. Wow. And then we got the World card again. So completion of that cycle. That's this card right here. And then we got the Knight of Cups. Awesome. It's trusting. It is letting go and allowing. The Knight of Cups is also a gesture of love. It's poetic. It's romance. So he wants to offer his love to the object of his desires, the Queen of Wands. And the Eight of Pentacles is about working in the 3D world, establishing a firm foundation, and there's a sense of rest and peace as he walks through the garden. Thank you for that clarification, Spirit. Namaste. So that was for these three cards. So he is going to be walking away from conflict. He's going from this closed state to speaking his truth, walking away from the bullshit, and towards his dreams. And they will be manifested. So Spirit is asking to have patience. There will be that completion. So for the final outcome for the feminine. Oh my God. Strength card again. So she got that in her near future. So this is going to be a final outcome energy. So again, this is being empowered, using your will, determination to deal with people and situations, but also taming the beast within. And it's more of a strength from kindness and compassion rather than exerting your will on something. But it is showing your strength and courage. Wow, Knight of Cups again. Six of Wands. And the Page of Swords. So, the Knight of Cups. We saw that earlier with the Osho cards. So this is a gesture of love coming towards you. Somebody's going to be wearing their heart on their sleeve. It's poetic. It is an expression of your heart's desire. It is a longing and a yearning for union. So he is a knight in shining armor. The Six of Wands is success and victory. It is accomplishment. It is harvest. It is being, cheered for, being recognized. People are using you as an example. People are proud of you. So there's a sense of being placed on a pedestal and recognized for all of the hard work that you've done. And now there's going to be abundance coming towards you in the form of love and communication. The Page of Swords is open, honest communication. It is speaking your truth. And pages are messengers, so that means that it could be in the form of text message or a phone call, but it is communication. So the truth will be spoken. And it will be because you are in the state of strength. So yeah, beautiful. You have grown into your power. Big heavy hitter cards there. So next we have the masculine's final outcome. Are you kidding me? The Four of Wands. So this is the 11-11 calling card for the John Holland deck. So this means that an 11-11 twin flame connection, reunion, or union will be taking place in his future. Or it could mean that sense of arrival or accomplishment, time to celebrate, time to feel peace and harmony and rest and love, all the good things. The Knight of Swords. The King of Wands. Beautiful. And then the Seven of Swords. Interesting. So he got it twice. He got the Seven of Swords just below this. So he's still carrying this energy into his future as an outcome. So the Knight of Swords is a sudden energy. It comes in very quick. And it is about communicating your truth. He is a rebel without a cause. He is the champion. He is justice. So there is clarity of thought as well, and it's a grounding of an idea into the reality. So it seems to me like either he will come into the truth of the twin flame connection and speak his truth, or go forward towards that manifestation or dream, or it will come towards him. I don't know. It's hard to say with the Seven of Swords here. It's kind of confusing. Then we have the King of Wands. This is actually Brad Pitt from, anybody know what movie that is? Anyway, it is that fiery energy. He's the leader. He tells people what to do. He is the, you know, inventor, the creator. He commands people. He makes his, the things that he's passionate about, these creative inspirations, he makes them grounded in reality. So last week I referred to him as the center of the sun, really coming into his power. So it looks like he's arriving at this twin flame connection as the King of Wands on his horse of truth, of purity. But here we have that Seven of Swords. What an unusual energy to come across. Does not fit with the next, with the rest of the reading. So this is a sense of being deceived, like somebody's going to stab you in the back. So what I'm getting from this is that perhaps there's a sense that he needs to leave a situation under the cover of night. But I don't know why he would do that, because we got this Knight of Swords here, who speaks his truth. So I'm going to pull a card for that. There seems to be a lot of sword activity going on. Confliction of the mind. So maybe it's just a warning, you know, because we got this, you know, facing your shadow aspect and telling the truth, seeing the truth. So maybe that comes to light in the future. I don't know. Okay, so I want to pull a clarifier for the Seven of Swords, please. What the heck, Spirit? For real. It doesn't make any sense at all. Because there's a reflection here. We got the Page of Swords and the Knight of Swords. And again, that's communicating your truth. And there's a sense of victory, harvest, return. And then that nasty Seven of Swords. Conditioning, the Devil card. So, this is realizing that you are the lion amongst the sheep. That it's releasing yourself from those, the chain, the lies. So actually, I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to pause the video and I will read this card to you. Because there's a sense that he moves away or realizes the truth about something, which awakens him in some way. But first, I'm going to look at the bottom of the deck for the overall energy. Base chakra, awesome. So this is a grounding energy. It is a that start in the 3D world. It is actually making it happen. This is the seed, kind of like the idea. And this is the actual planting of the seed, the grounding of that energy. So it is a shared energy. Okay. And then I'm going to pull two cards. One representing the feminine energy in terms of the base chakra, and then the masculine. Seven of Pentacles. So again, this talks about the weight. It is doing the work and the pregnant pause, waiting for that harvest. But when this card shows up, it means that the wait is almost over. So she's waiting for the tide to turn. So she might as well just go surf on the other side of the island or something. I don't know. But chillax. Have patience. It's coming. And for the masculine, wow, the Ten of Swords. That is the manifestation of this card. It is working your entire life. And finally being at that point of rest where you don't have to worry about money anymore. You are finding joy, peace, and bliss in being with the people that you love. So it is that arrival. It is that final resting place. It is accomplishment in the 3D world. It is manifesting your dreams in the 3D to a point where you feel comfortable and you don't have to worry about money anymore. So we got the base chakra here, Ten of Pentacles. The beginning, the end. So he sees that dream. He's working towards that final happy ending. And there's a sense that the feminine is in a peaceful state, resting state. The pregnant pause. Good. Now, so I'll stop it there because I'm going to be using the Archangel Power Tarot card. I can't remember if I mentioned the cards at the beginning of the reading, but I'm using Osho Zen, John Holland Psychic Tarot, Call It Baron Reed, Chanted Map, Archangel Power Tarot cards, and I may be reading from the Tarot Illuminati. Okay, so one moment. So conditioning. This card recalls an old Zen story about a lion who was brought up by sheep and who thought he was a sheep until an old lion captured him and took him to a pond, where he showed him his own reflection. Many of us are like the lion. The image we have of ourselves comes not from our own direct experiences, but from the opinions of others. A personality imposed from the outside replaces the individuality that could have grown from within. We become just another sheep in the herd, unable to move freely and unconscious of our own true identity. It's time to take a look at your own reflection in the pond and make a move to break out of whatever you have been conditioned by others to believe about yourself. Dance, run, jog, do gibberish, whatever is needed to wake up the sleeping lion within. So yeah, there's a real sense that he is facing a shadow aspect, and I'm getting that he will be moving away from those, you know, negative thought patterns. It seems to me that somebody is accusing him of being a certain way, and it is causing him to awaken into his power. So remember the rest of the cards. They had the Knight of Swords, which is speaking your truth, knowing your truth, being that champion. And then we have the King of Wands, who is in his power. And then, of course, we have the Four of Wands, which is manifesting your dreams, desire, but it's all about passion and desire as well. So there's a lot of fire energy and completion. It's coming into your truth.
I'm back. So I know you probably can't see all the cards, but I will be showing them to you shortly. I'll be going through each position and giving you a summary of the reading. All right, so this is going to be for the union energy. What is the Divine Feminine bringing into the union? Divine Guidance. So this is the High Priest. Where is that card? Right here. I don't know if you can see it or not. But he is spiritually guided. He is tapped into the Akashic Records. He is downloading wisdom and knowledge in order to share with others. So it says here, the search for meaning in life, consider an alternative approach. Surround yourself with wise teachers or friends. So there's a sense that the feminine have really stepped into their leadership roles in terms of their divine purpose. So they are using their light within in order to draw others out of the darkness. So there's a sense that you guys are really stepping into your... Wow, I don't know what's up with these cards. They won't stay in my hand. It's so bizarre. So you're fulfilling your life purpose. For the Divine Masculine, the Seven of Ariel again. So this is the waiting card. It's this card here, and I thought the feminine got it before, but I guess not. That's the harvest is coming. The wait is almost over. Good things come to those who wait. So it says, you have invested wisely, have patience and wait for the harvest, review progress and make plans for the next endeavor. So this is also a reflection stage as well. So it's a reevaluation of the past and deciding what things need to be released in order for you to freely move in the future. So there's a sense that the wait is almost over. For the foundation energy, the Queen of Wands, perfect. The King of Wands showed up in as an outcome, him stepping into his power, being the center of the sun. So the Queen of Wands is the object of his desire. You are also the Sun Queen. You are the center of the sun. So both twins are, you know, coming into their fullness, their light. They're being illuminated. You can do anything right now. Go after what you want, the ability to attract helpful people. So, you know, I really think this kind of represents the feminine coming into her power as well. So there's that kind of that role reversal happening right now. Yeah. So we'll leave it at that. I'm going to be pulling clarifiers for these cards. So the crowning energy is beautiful. The magician, the master manifester. This is having an idea and bringing that idea into the material world. So making your dreams a reality. It says you can manifest the life you want. What you need will magically appear. Successful beginnings. So it is a number one energy crowning. And then we got that one base chakra up there. So 11. Yes, so the magician is able to tap into zero point energy, pull that energy from source and make, you know, his ideas a reality. So there's a grounding energy that is coming with that card. A heart-centered energy. Wow, King of Michael. So we have a progression here. We have the Page of Cups, or sorry, the Queen of Cups, the Page of Cups, and the Knight of Cups. All the cup suits are being represented to this culmination of the King. So it says wisdom and objectivity are important now. Stay in your integrity, a situation that calls for honest and open communication. So there's a sense that there's a deception taking place with the two sevens. And some truths aren't being spoken. They need to be revealed and illuminated. And it seems to me like you are both coming into that sense of truth. You know what is right. Your true calling. But it could also represent communication as well. Instead of using Osho cards for further clarification, I'm going to pull a miniature crystal ball reading. So it'll be a 3x3 grid. So a crystal ball reading is my newest reading. So it is a freeze frame of the energy taking place in the recent past, the present, and the near future. And it will be in regards to this King of Michael here, this speaker of truth, this communication. So it will reflect the heart-centered energy. Okay, Spirit, what do you mean by the King of Michael? This clarity of thought, this clear communication. So the first row will represent the near, the recent past. Wow, the divine masculine, twin flame. Wow, he's stepping into his truth. He is living his true authentic life. That is absolutely beautiful. I'm just going to put this up here for a moment so you can see the cards and that and reflect on it as well. So it's like the wait is over, and now he can finally be who he is meant to be. So when I made this card, I made it with this, the idea that it represented nothing other than the fact that this is a divine masculine twin flame. So card one. Next card. The Wheel of Fortune. Justin Timberlake's song. Goes around, comes around. So what you put out, you get back. What you reap, you sow. But this also talks about a period of change. The winds of change have come in. And luck is on your side. So karma is coming back to you in a good way. So it's like these two cards together. It's like recent past, he has gone through this cycle of change, completed a cycle, and allowed a transformation to occur, and has now being represented in his true divine self. Final card. Wow, the Queen of Cups could represent a water sign, but it has more to do with the divine feminine. She is represented as different aspects with the court cards. So the Queen of Swords is about speaking your truth. It's about communication, clarity of thought, cutting through the bullshit, whereas the Queen of Cups is about love, feeling love, being open to love, and it's about being that open receptacle, allowing love to flow through you. So here we got the Divine Masculine, the Wheel of Fortune, and the Queen of Cups. What a beautiful group of cards. So yeah, your heart-centered openness has helped this wheel of change draw the masculine into his ultimate power. Okay, so for the next row is going to be the present position. The Nine of Wands. This is the wounded warrior. This is being knocked down over and over and over again and continuing to get back and up and fight. It is wanting to give up and walk away. It's battle wounds, scars. The muscles are aching. You know, you're mentally, physically, and emotionally exhausted to the point where you want to collapse and give in. But then Spirit is telling you, you know, don't do that. Tap into that inner strength and fight that one last battle. You still have the strength within you to, you know, go through this final challenge. So that is below the Divine Masculine card. Well, we'll see what the other cards say. The Hermit. So presently, this is the middle card. So this card, this position represents 0 point. So it is the main focus of the crystal ball reading. This is the main energy. And from that, it spreads out in every direction towards the cards around it. So the main focus is the Hermit. It is withdrawing from society's constraints and unchaining yourself. It reminds me of the movie Into the Wild, where the man, you know, burns his money and cuts up his credit cards and detaches completely. And he lives off the land, and he is happier than he's ever been in his life. So it's about getting in touch with your spiritual self, your inner self, and getting pure joy in the aloneness. So, sorry. It's a sense that he is coming back from this wounded state as this centered, wise leader, in a way. The hermit always comes back in order to share his knowledge with others. He finds his light within and in order to light the way for others. So this card is the present, but it is the energy that was brought in from the past. So there's a sense that he needed to retreat in order to heal these wounds and recuperate, find his center again. And from that, he was able to find his truth. Okay, so this will be the final card for the present. So this will be the energy brought into the future. Five of Pentacles. So this talks about shooting yourself in the foot. You either be released from a situation or occurring some kind of losses, financial losses. But you want to be released from a situation, and that may require a loss of some kind in the 3D world. This could also represent an energy of feeling like you're left out in the cold. It's a time of hardship. So I think there's, you know, here we have someone who is wounded, exhausted. And then on the other side, we have somebody who is taking a financial loss. But at the center of the reading, we have the hermit who is in a state of stillness, of knowing, who has detached himself from the material world and its conditionings. He is awake. And he has been able to heal his heart and let go of the past. So even though there is a financial loss that will result as a result of him going forward, he is at peace with it. Or he could feel like he shot himself in the foot in regards to his emotional retreat with the Queen of Swords. I don't know. It's one idea. All right, so this is going to be the near future. Wow, Three of Cups. So this means union for me. But it is not the explosive union like the Lover's card, or one level higher like the Temperance, where the souls intertwine. It's the zipping of the helix in the DNA. This is more of an expression of love and celebrating love. It is the feeling of having, of knowing it's true love because of the way it makes you feel. It excites you. You feel it moving through you. It connects you to something higher than yourself. So it's union. And that is right below the Nine of Wands and the Divine Masculine. So there's a sense that even though he was in the eye of the storm presently, he's at peace internally, and his vision is a union in the future. Eight of Wands, communication, or it represents an Cupid's arrows. So the Eight of Wands You know, it could represent literally texting on the phone, sending messages, or talking. Or it could represent Cupid's arrows, love coming towards you. It is reaching for the stars, seeing your highest goals and expectations, and having that energy coming back to you. It's dreams realized. So, yeah, there's this karmic energy. You know, he retreated, went within in search of his soul, and emerged, you know, as this pure energy, this star in the sky, making his dreams manifest. And my apologies if this reading appears to be geared directly to the masculine. That is not my intention. It is just the way the energy seems to be presenting itself right now. Yeah, it seems to be a lot of masculine energy here, of fighting, releasing, and, you know, there's a peaceful state with the feminine. Her chakras are open. She's arriving at this place of completion with her divine masculine, who has, you know, stepped into this leader, this you know, spiritually conscious leader. And so there's a sense of release and peace, except for this Ten of Swords, but that means it's the end of it. It is the walking away of it. It's no more, because the Four of Wands is the truth. Everything else is the lie. But on the masculine side, we have this shadow aspect here. And then we have the two Seven of Swords. They're not heavy energy by any means. It's just a transition to me. It's that final purging, that final letting go of these nagging thoughts that haven't truly been addressed. You know, and realizing your power as the lion. All right, so the final card is going to represent the, more or less, the distant future, I guess. Wow, the Ace of Cups, awesome. Brand new beginning in love. But I was just noticing here that we have a progression from the divine masculine coming into the 3D and then manifesting this brand new love here. So this is being an open vessel. One moment. My apologies. I just got a wicked tickle in my throat. Okay. So usually when I get a tickle in my throat, that means communication. And that was right beside the Eight of Wands card here, which means communication. And earlier we had... And this is Cupid's arrow, so it's an energy of love coming towards you. So in the, as an outcome, there will be this abundance of love, a new start of love. So that is what is going on with the King of Swords. So it seems to me like this energy represented here is mostly about the King and his journey to truth, enlightenment. Okay, so we'll be having a look at these cards and, give you a summary. But next I'm going to pull two cards from Call It Bear and Read, and I will be reading those for you. What is the message for the Divine Feminine, please? Final message from the universe. Rescue. Just put it here. And for the Divine Masculine, Goblins. See, I told you. It seems to me that the Divine Masculine is going through a final purge, letting go of those last little nagging goblins that have been whispering in his ear. That is an absolutely perfect card. All right, I shall see you in a moment.
Hi guys, I am back. So here is your reading. All right, so overall, the energy seems to be focused on the divine masculine right now. And the divine feminine is holding this centered energy. She is in her power. She is emotionally balanced, disconnected from negativity. She has gone through this major transformation in the past, which has opened up this field of potential and abundance coming towards her. She has released negative people, negative situations, and she is in her heart centered. Her fire, her passion has been ignited. We have this strength, this I can, will, exert it forward. And here in the present position, her passion is ignited. Her emotions are ignited. And it is a result of this twin flame connection, which is leading her ultimately to this completion, this final ending, allowing for a new beginning, the beginning of the fool's journey. And we see her stepping into her power, mounting her horse, and riding towards her destiny, towards this manifestation, to this abundance. And here we have the divine masculine beside her. But there's a real sense that she's stepping into her calling, her life purpose. She's done the work, and the divine masculine is joining her. He's definitely there with her in the 5D, but there's a sense that this twin flame union will be manifested in the 3D soon. The wait is almost over. So as a final outcome, we have this strength again emerging, which is drawing this love towards her. And we have that expression of love with the Knight of Cups, success, triumph, but she's standing in her truth. So this could come in the form of a message or communication of that truth. But she's very in her center, in her knowing. Look at these cards. Isn't that amazing? It's beautiful. Okay, so over to the masculine. Again, we have this Ace of Pentacles, which shows up here. So the seed has been planted for this beautiful, happy ending. And it has been planted because the masculine has come into his truth. He sees the possibilities of his dreams manifested and the truth of this spiritual union, and has basically walked through that proverbial door towards his higher calling union. So he made the decision to move away from negativity, from fear in the past, and plant this seed. So in the present position, he's still going through a purge. He is facing his shadow aspects. It is the dark night of the soul, but it isn't one that is all-consuming. It is to release this feeling like you're being deceived, not knowing all the truth. It is a lingering feeling. Even though you know what your truth is, there's still this sense that something needs to be released in order for him to fully step into his heart chakra and express love as the King of Cups. And here we have the Divine Feminine with him in the 5D, providing strength and guidance in his journey. But it appears that he knows what his final destination will be. And so there's movement, a call to action to face your fears, get in touch with your emotions, your heart chakra, and there's a movement towards his goal, his highest aim. As an outcome, we have this deception coming to the forefront, and it's as if he deals with it. There's a sense that he moves from this closed-off state to speaking his truth, seeing through the bullshit, seeing through the lies, which could come in the form of communication from the Divine Feminine. But I think the Divine Feminine in this position is holding truth, which allows him to move from this unknowing to a sense of being open and feeling like your ships are coming in, like there's a harvest, there's a return. He's able to see through the deception and the lies, which moves him from this closed off to an open state. As the final outcome, we have the Four of Wands, 11-11 connection. And here we have him sitting, you know, but in his power as the King of Wands. And this 11-11 connection comes in very suddenly. And it comes with his truth and his knowing. And this Seven of Swords is released. And it is released in the sense that he realizes that he is the lion amongst the sheep, that he is the divine, you know, the center of the sun. So for some, this is not for all. It looks to me like, you know, there's the final, last little pieces of the puzzle are coming into place. So there's a purge, opening his heart chakra and a movement forward. So this little bit of clearing needs to be released before there's that final arrival. So once again, moving to, you know, the overall energy, it is definitely reflected in the reading. We got that base chakra. So we have the seed being planted in the past on both sides. So there is that grounded energy, in that base chakra is safety, security, a sustenance. It is, you know, feeling of security and grounding in the 3D. And so there was a great deal of work put into this 3D by the Divine Feminine and the Masculine. These are pentacles here. We got the Ten of Pentacles and the Seven of Pentacles. Ten of Pentacles talks about that ultimate destination where you have your home, it's paid off, you're kind of in this retirement state. You don't have to worry about money anymore. You are surrounded by your friends and family, and that's what matters most. So the foundation has been laid, the seed has been firmly planted, and now, you know, there's a sense that there's a growth. The two aspects have been working together to, you know, create this future. And now Spirit is saying that the wait is almost over. The Seven of Pentacles is about working hard in the 3D, but also waiting for that return. So the Seven of Pentacles says that the wait is almost over. Good things come to those who wait. So moving on to the union energy. The feminine is bringing in the High Priest. Again, a repeated card. But the way I'm reading this card is that she is guiding the masculine. He is guiding her. He shows up on her side beside this completion card. You know, the World card. It's an ultimate completion. And then she shows up over here when he's dealing with his fears, his shadow self. She is there offering him peace. So there's a sense that they're both guiding each other through this process. They are connected in the 5D, and they are helping each other when it matters. They are always there, connected. The masculine is bringing in the Seven of Pentacles, so that's that repeated card there. So they both are holding this energy of waiting. It's that pregnant pause. There is a period of gestation. So he's bringing in this energy of that wait is nearing the end of completion. The harvest is coming. So the grounding energy, the foundation, is the Queen of Wands. So I'm taking this as the Queen coming in as the object of his desire, his dreams manifest, the Queen in her fiery state, because the masculine ultimately comes in as the King of Wands as the final outcome. So she's providing this grounded energy while he goes through this final purge. So the crowning energy is the Magician. So this is making that foundation, that seed, actually manifested in the 3D. It is a set intention. The seed is growing. So, yeah, there's a sense that they are both sharing this energy of manifesting that 3D connection. The heart-centered energy is the King. So, again, she is providing that grounding energy, that fuel to the fire, so that he can have mental clarity and find his truth as he moves through this dark night of the soul, if you want to call it. Yeah, I would definitely call it a dark night of the soul, but it is not a treacherous one. It is not like a major purge, like I said. There's a sense that it's coming to completion, because over on the feminine side, in the same position, this is the present position, we have the Ten of Swords, which is also the dark night of the soul. But it is that final ending. It is no more. And from that comes the Four of Wands, that 11-11 twin flame union. But ultimately, it requires a calming of the mind. So she knows what she wants. She's done her work. But there's a sense that she's providing a grounded energy in the form of a twin flame connection, so that these final things can be released. So he seems to be, like I said, the focus here. When we look at the 3x3 grid here, we can see that the Hermit is at the center. So there's a sense that he is on a quest for truth, and the Queen of Swords ultimately begins that transformation towards being, you know, from closed to open. And he emerges at the center of the reading as this King in his truth, speaking his truth, knowing his truth, seeing the truth, and living the truth. And in order to do that, he needed to retreat as the Hermit, go off on a spiritual journey, which is a reason for the delay. And, you know, there's a sense that he really connected with his divine light, his truth, his knowing. And from it came the Wheel of Change. And again, we got the Divine Feminine in this loving state as the Queen of Cups. So again, it's that grounded energy, that silence, that strength, that knowing, that peace. It's just allowing. It is disconnecting from the outcome. This is I can, and this is I want.
So it's like she disconnected from, you know, wanting, needing, yearning, and instead decided to still the water, still her mind, still, you know, become calm and focus on, you know, the love and the future. So yeah, she's providing this grounded silence and knowing. And that is giving him the strength to go through this process. So here we have the Nine of Wands being in the center of the storm. So presently, he is still in a hermit state, but he's really finding his power to, you know, fight that final battle, you know, release the things that he needs to release in the 3D world. And like I said, it will come with a loss, but there's a sense that he knows that he has no attachment of the ego to these 3D things, these 3D pleasures. It's okay to him if he takes a loss, because ultimately it has no meaning, because what's the truth is destiny. That's what the Wheel of Fortune is. It's destiny. It's the coming together of the twin flames. And she's standing here with her heart chakra open in a sense of allowing, which is drawing the masculine into his true form. So like I said, something is being released currently in the present. He's going through that dark night of the soul, getting in touch with his emotions, becoming, you know, that emotional King of Cups, opening his heart chakra and getting in touch with his spiritual knowing in order to fully be open to this outcome, this beautiful outcome, the Three of Cups, union, Eight of Wands, communication, but also Cupid's arrows. It's reaching for the stars and touching the stars and having them manifested as your dreams and goals are there right in front of you. And the Ace of Cups, which is the brand new beginning of love. It is that new start. It is being at that point in your life where you have let go of the pain, let go of your fears, and forgiven others, stepped into your truth and your knowing and your power, and opened your heart chakra. And then and only then will this card appear. So ultimately he, you know, becomes love, pure love, as his final outcome. So yeah, I love how, you know, each four cards here are the cornerstones for the reading. So we have the Divine Masculine there. One moment. So sorry about that. The four cornerstones, we have the Three of Cups, the Divine Masculine, the Queen of Cups, and the Ace of Cups. So the love is encasing, surrounding the Divine Masculine as he goes through this hermit stage. So there's a sense that there's energy, you know, these four cards here are, you know, fighting, battling, conquering. This here is Cupid's arrows. It's an energy coming towards him. Here, you know, there's a sense of being left out in the dark. It's cold. He's wounded. And then the Wheel of Fortune is an energy. It's the wind of change coming in. So there's a lot of activity going on in the past, the present, and the future. But here he stands, in a state of knowing, unchained. And the reason why he is unchained is to open his heart chakra and ultimately step into the King of Cups. See what I mean? We have the 5D aspect, him retreating, going within, seeking spiritual knowledge so that he can really become the King of Cups and be that open vessel. Okay, so yeah, I hope this made sense and I hope you enjoyed it. So yeah, I'll read those cards to you now. So the five divine guidance, which is the High Priestess, is the energy that the feminine is bringing into the reading. And the Seven of Pentacles is the Divine Masculine's energy. So, divine guidance. There is no need to be alone. There are amazing people around you from whom you would gain great strength and support. Seek out those who are like-minded and who share your beliefs and ideals. Make new friends who would benefit from your insights and affection. Take a class on spirituality or join an organization that aims to do good in the world. Archangel Sandalphon can help you find the meaning you're seeking in your life. Be open to other people's ideas and perspectives, but don't be bound by them. If you're taking a very traditional approach to your challenges and things just don't seem to be moving forward, then it might be time to think outside the box. On the other hand, if you attempt to be creative in merely reinventing the wheel, perhaps the old-fashioned way would be better. So I'm just kind of seeing this card as you providing that divine guidance for the union. You're kind of standing here in your knowing and being that spiritual leader. And this card also represents being divinely guided as well. So the Seven of Wands. Your seeds are well planted. However, some plans do take time to develop. Now is not the moment to stop, as success is very probable. You may not see it clearly, but slow and steady progress is being made. Have patience. It's almost time. This is a good opportunity to pause and review how far you've come. Are things moving along as you planned? If not, what changes might you make in the future? If you're at the end of a project, don't linger too long finishing up. The next success awaits your attention. This represents the shared energy. For the foundation, we got the Queen of Gabriel. Situation. Speak your mind with confidence. This situation calls for honest and open communication. Oh, sorry. That would have been the King of Michael. My apologies. Let me just move to the Queen of Wands. So, situation. You can do anything right now. You may not fully grasp how wonderful you are, but those around you definitely see it. It's time to believe in yourself. Your kind eagerness to help others in their lives will attract people willing to do the same for you. If it is a person, it's a very charming person whom everyone likes. Someone who is able to balance all aspects of his or her life with ease and grace. Passionate, independent, friendly, beautiful, popular, business, confident, and brilliant, and unwavering. Whoa, look at that. She just wavered. Get back up there. I told you, the energy is so bizarre today. Things falling constantly. Okay, the King of Michael. Situation. Speak your mind with confidence. The situation calls for honest and open communication. If you're uncertain what to do, then hire an expert. While wisdom and objectivity are important now, don't forget to weigh the emotional aspects of the situation. Make sure your actions are of the highest integrity. If it's a person who commands great respect and is known for being fair, someone who communicates very professionally, principled, rational, ambitious, and diplomatic. So that's the heart-centered energy. And for the crowning energy, the Magician. You have the magical touch of angels on your side. New projects that you start will be very successful. You have all the resources you need, even if you can't see them at this time. You may be underestimating the skill and knowledge that you've accumulated. You're prepared for this moment in your life, and the road ahead is safe and sure. With Archangel Raziel beside you, additional assistance in the form of guidance, supportive people, or windfall of abundance will seem to magically appear. Anything is possible. However, to receive this help, you have to confidently take action. You must move forward with your plans in a way that displays to others and to yourself that you have no doubt as to your coming success. Yeah, baby. So the feminine got rescue. You are always safe and secure and free to be yourself. So this is the message from the universe. Asking for help isn't easy for many successful people. However, that's what you need to do now to expand your life. If you find yourself troubled, you can expect help with whatever issues is at hand now. You need only ask, and assistance will come your way. The most important support you can expect is from spirit. Get into the right relationship with the divine, and you'll see that many conditions line up, if as if by magic, to provide you with all the help you need. Ask and you shall receive. There is no need to fear. Safety is a place within. And the masculine got goblins. Fear is an illusion. Choose love today. Forgive yourself and others. Goblins are born when you're wounded and something essential is lost in that experience. From that point on, as you forget your wholeness, they remain with you in the shadows. There, they remind you of what brought them into being. By mimicking your voice, tricking you into believing that you're unworthy, victimized, and unlovable. They hold you hostage through low self-worth, self-sabotage, and the feeling that you're lacking what you need. If goblins pay you a visit, know that they represent the shadow of your own self or someone else's, and that they are leading you into a potentially reactive situation. A goblin's card appearance is an opportunity for growth. However, a signal that you must love yourself. No human is without flaws. The goblin's message is that you must release resentment and negative self-talk. Within you is the spark of the divine. Ask spirit to help you heal. Miracles can and do happen. Let go of the negativity. All right, I hope you enjoyed this reading. Much love to you. We'll see you next week.